feel like I just woke you up. Everybody like looked up from their phones like, oh, something happened. Let's try that again. Hi, everybody.
Hello.
How are we this afternoon?
Good.
All right, feel good. Staying cool from the heat outside?
Yes. Yeah.
Too cool.
All right, very cool. Well, my name's Sam. I'm the moderator. I'm not important, but I am here to sort of make sure that the ground rules are set so that we can have an awesome panel here. Super excited. So for this, we want to kind of keep it on the Q&A side of things. So as you can see, we've got two microphones on either side of the aisles here. So what'll happen is we'll just create some lines. You guys can ask questions. It's that simple. The only request we have is that you not ask for things like hugs or selfies. There is an opportunity to do things like that, autographs and that sort of thing at Sarah's table in the exhibitors hall. And that's pretty much it. Let's just keep the questions family friendly. There was a lot of cool experience to learn about here today. If there is, you know, if there's like sightline issues, we're not going to have that in here, but if there's sightline issues, if there's too many people standing, then that's not going to be a problem with this panel. So, all right, very cool. So with your round of applause, I would like to welcome to the table Sarah Nataceni. So we've got the voice of Ash Ketchum,
yeah.
The Mist, right here.
That's me.
So I think we can, there's a ton of experiences that we can talk about right here, so I would like to go ahead and open up the panel to questions from the audience. There's lots that we can ask, and if you don't ask questions, then I'm going to ask them, and my questions are not as good as yours.
Please don't make him ask questions. Please ask me questions.
All right, we've got our first brave volunteer over here.
So far.
So, when you first auditioned for the role and then got it, did you realize that you were going to be committing to such a huge, multi-year, big franchise thing, and like how big it became, or did it just happen all kind of like gradually for you?
Well, it was already big. I started at season 9, and it was already like this huge show. So I realized, I understood the magnitude of it. I didn't really, I was 19, so I wasn't like thinking about my future that much. So yeah, maybe not, I didn't think, oh, I'd be 29 and like still doing this, no. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah,
hi.
So my first question, this is from my youngest cousin, because she couldn't be here. Mm-hmm. What was it like voicing Ash for the first time?
Terrifying. Oh, so terrifying. I felt like I didn't know what I was doing, and I probably should. And exhilarating. Yeah.
And my second question is, of all the places your version of Ash has been to, which has to be your favorite out of all of them?
Alola. It's beautiful there.
Yeah, it reminds me of my second hometown, Hawaii, so thank you.
Awesome. Yeah, I want to go there real bad. Hello.
Hi, thank you so much for coming out to Comic-Con today. Speaking as someone who is obsessed with Pokemon from like 3rd to 5th grade, like everything, the card games, the Game Boy games, the theme song. So thank you so much for being such a big part of my childhood. So there's this crazy theory that I heard about recently, and I thought it was crazy, and then I started thinking about it, like, oh wait, this could have some merit to it. At the end of episode 1 or 2, after Ash gets attacked by the Spearows, he falls into a coma, and he's rushed to the hospital, and he's just been in the coma, and Pokemon is like an entire dream world that he's been thinking of this entire time, and that's why he never ages, and that's why Pikachu never ages. Just wanted to get your take on that. Freak you out. I had the same reaction.
Oh my god. Yeah. That's gotta be it. That's
okay. It all makes sense.
That makes a lot of sense.
It's a rock solid theory.
That's a rock solid theory.
That's it. Geo.
There's a ton of support online.
Really? I must check that out. That's I agree. I can't speak for the producers. I don't speak for the show, but I agree. There's no other reason for him not to age. It's a dream.
It's all I said.
It's all I said.
Ash is still in a coma.
I'm in a coma. What? Next question.
Hello.
Hello.
I saw the Pokemon 25th movie of anniversary where Ash first meets Pikachu. I wonder if you've heard about it before.
Oh yeah, the 20th movie?
The 25th anniversary movie where Ash first Pikachu.
Yeah, no, this is season 20. It's the 20th movie. It's okay. It's not 25 years, right? Am I nuts? It's 20 years. It's 20 years.
The movie is coming up for
the 25th anniversary of the show.
25th anniversary of the show. Oh, darn.
It's 20th, yeah.
Oh, darn.
Usually fans know a lot more than I do. And because I was into the show when I was like 10 years old when it first came out. And then I kind of, got swept up in my studies. So sometimes I'm embarrassed, but that's, it's 20. Anyway, yes, I knew about it, and I love that it came back. And this movie is really great. This is my favorite movie to date, actually. This most recent one. It's really good.
Can I just ask another one from here?
Yeah, sure.
Is there any lines that you've said where you've seen it and then gone like, why am I saying this? It's like, were they like whitewashing it now, like in the earlier seasons when they like see rice balls and they say donut? Or something? Are there any times when you say something and you're like, I know this is not what the original line was?
Oh, wow. It happens. It happens that we fix it like right as I'm saying it. I say it and I'm like, that's not right. Let's not say that. And we change it. We give the producers options.
What was the hardest thing you ever had to pronounce?
Oh god.
The question was, what was the hardest thing you've ever had to pronounce?
I had to say Clement a lot. Clement. Clement. And when you put it with another word, it's a hard thing to say. Like Clement, come here. Clement. Clement.
Do you believe in climate change?
Oh boy!
Oh boy.
I mean, it's hard not to believe in climate change.
It rolls right out the tongue. Hey, we have a question from this side.
Yeah. Hello.
So, you dubbed some of the Alola episodes. I was wondering, what do you think about it visually compared to the rest of the Pokemon series thus far?
I absolutely, no, sorry.
Because it's taken a bit of a comedic turn, but it's also a bit more characterized.
Yeah. It's darker, it's funnier, it's way more fun for me to do. It's way more fun for me to see his face and have to match, like, a really... It's always been well-animated, but really well-animated face. There's some real style to it now. I love it. It's great. Is everybody enjoying this season? Pretty rad, no?
Looking forward to meeting Misty and Brock again.
Huh?
I said, are you looking forward to meeting Misty and Brock again?
Always, I miss them so much. Aww. I love those friends. I don't know.
No, I said I can't wait to meet them too.
Oh, I see. No, I can't wait also, but I don't know when that's going to happen.
Soon.
For sure, soon.
Soon in Japan, later in
England. Later here, yeah. Who else? Who got a question?
All right.
Got a question.
Okay.
Actually, I have a two-part question.
Okay.
First of all, what's your favorite of the games to play, and do you have a like go-to team?
Okay. So I was not allowed to play games as a kid. Fun, right? But I do play Pokemon Go, and my friends kind of hate me for it.
I think it doesn't take my attention away from the conversation. I'm catching Pokemon and transferring them. It's really not, it doesn't take much brain power to do that. So that's my favorite game, because it's my only game. And the second part, sorry.
And do you have a
team.
Oh, what's your like a team or a favorite Pokemon that you like to use?
Well, I'm Team Mystic.
There's a few out there.
Yeah. Hello, newcomers. I'm Team Mystic. I usually drop off my Rhydon at the gyms. You know, it's real powerful, real strong. Tends to stay longer. I get more coins. I have my Pokemon storage. It's great. We're doing a Q&A. Welcome, if you're just joining us.
We got Eevee in the house.
Ask me really fun questions, weird questions. How do I live? How do I exist? How do you do what's that? Hi, yes. Yeah, this most recent one, and I'm afraid to give anything away, but a Pokemon dies.
Oh yeah.
Oh my god. My director and I both cried, and that's what inspired Voices for Fosters, our nonprofit organization to benefit animal foster organizations. So, something really good came of that, but that was a really hard episode to do. My cat had just passed away. When I had to record that episode. So that was fun. Yeah. Also, I really liked playing Super Pikachu. I played Super Pikachu in an episode. That was great. That made me happy. What else?
Over here. Hi there. Do you ever look back at older episodes you've done and wish you emphasized something differently or changed anything?
Sure, all the time.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Oh God. I don't really like to watch my work, but it's something you need to do as an actor. It's educational. I don't remember specifically. I try not to remember things like that. Puts a damper on my day. But there have been times, especially early on, when fans not fans of mine, would write to me and be like, "You suck." And I'd be like, "Why are they saying that?" And then I would go and watch the episodes and be like, "I see now." Cool. Set. So, there's a curve. Hi.
Hi. Did you originally audition for Ash Ketchum, a male character, or was there a female character on the show that you're trying to voice?
No, Ash Ketchum was my original audition. And ever since then, I've been auditioning for a lot of boy roles. Yeah. I think they'd already had the other voices cast, perhaps. I'm not really sure. But that's all I read for.
Do you have, he was talking about Brock and Misty. Are there other sort of voice actors when you're going in to record that you look forward to spending time with or just hanging out with? Or
never.
No. lone wolf.
Lone wolf. Actually, I am.
Oh my god, my special guest!
Hi.
Hi.
Not Jeremy that I actually Shaver. Ever get to work with her, but we're cool. So
we're cool.
If I did work, she'd be looking forward to come hanging out with me. So.
Exactly.
Can we have a round of applause for Jeremy Shaden?
What a
round
of applause over here. Jeremy Shaden.
I just had to wait for a good segue because there's no,
no good time to just
There's no
up.
Good time just to walk up.
No.
There's no good segue questions. No. So that was about the best I was going to get. So.
Right after she says she doesn't like to hang out with
you. What's wrong with you?
Hi.
She lit up when you showed up. It was perfect.
Yay. Have you guys been nice to her? Yes.
Yes.
Is that a mean name? Good. Okay, cool.
Sometimes people are really mean to me.
I know.
Because I'm the second voice of Ash Ketchum.
Yeah, you don't deserve it.
Exactly.
I know, right?
I mean, sometimes
you
I do.
Don't deserve it.
What can you do? It's part of the side effect of the businesses.
Yeah, but anyways, if you're mean to her, I will come and find you.
I hired
her. I'm her bodyguard. I'm really short, so you could probably take me on pretty easily, but
the strength is...
I'm scrappy.
You're scrappy.
I'm real scrappy.
I'm scrappy. We'll just be like...
Anyway.
Well, I've got a question for you. As two voice actors, as someone that loses their voice a lot, on the technical side of things, do you have like a cocktail or something that you use to keep going when it starts to get scratchy or sore, that sort of thing? Or like warm-ups that you're like, I don't even go near a booth without this?
I don't know what you do. I don't really do anything, to be
I
honest.
Nothing,
I mean,
too.
Once your voice is gone, it's just kind of gone.
You say I gotta come in next week.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. The only thing that occasionally I'll do is just get some lemon ginger tea with some honey in it.
Yeah.
It'll kind of extend a little bit of life in your voice, but once your voice is like super scratchy because you've been just yelling for 3 hours, there's not a whole lot you can a lot you can do. You're just kind of done at that point.
Yeah, there's nothing preventative that I do. Maybe it's because we're young still.
Yeah, I got some good pipes.
Yeah, yeah, we're still young and fresh. They self lubricate.
Yeah. So gross. That's such a gross word. Such a gross word.
Thank you. It's my forte.
On that note, I gotta go. So thanks, guys. Fun lubricating the cords, and yeah, we're good.
Jeremy Shannon, thank you so much.
You're welcome. See you guys. Yeah, see you later.
This is my neighbor. You should come to his table too. Important. And the voice should stay. It stays a little bit longer. I just shot a pilot 2 weeks ago, and I got my first cold in like 3 years, the day before we started filming, and it was like a bad cold. I was like, like, voice was leaving me every other take. I couldn't breathe. It was so stupid. But you know, you gotta just persevere and get through it, like Ash Ketchum would. What's that? It's got a hold on me. Oh, the character. Just recalled that, didn't you? Battling at full volume? Yeah, you gotta battle it. When you're an actor, you have to battle at full volume all the time. Because if you're not at full volume, battling at full volume, they'll fire you. And you don't want to get fired as an actor, because then word gets out and you know, nobody hires you. Hi.
What's the hardest Pokemon name you've ever had to say?
Like, of the Pokemon
either,
I play?
Either the one you hated, just, like, hated saying out loud, like, the hardest one to say, or they'll just playing just, you didn't like such the name of it, you didn't like pronouncing right it that way.
Right. Yeah, that's a good question. Greninja, that's not one of my favorites to say, but there is definitely one that I remember having to say a lot and being like, oh my god, not again. I don't remember now, maybe it'll come to me. Question.
There's a handful that are just difficult to say. They're just
so
many syllables and consonants.
Well, I don't have enough time saying it. Why? I can't imagine you actually having to do that.
Yeah.
Character.
Say it all the time, yeah.
Did you ever read one off the page and they were like, no, it's pronounced Gyarados.
Sometimes you get very, very specific, very minor notes on stuff like that. Oh god, it happened recently. Sorry. You say a million of these things for the last 11 years and it's all kind of a mush in my head. Oh god. And I'll probably never remember it. I don't have a great memory. So, but yeah, it happens. Yeah.
There are only hundreds and hundreds of Pokemon to recall.
Yeah.
I mean, even from the gate with the original 150 and 151, there were a handful that were like, depending on who your friends were was how you pronounced.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. It's Rattata, not Rattata. This is my advice to you.
All right, more questions. Again, my questions are lame, and you've got a rare opportunity right here. So feel free to just raise your hand, shout it out, whatever is coming to you. Questions about voice acting, the Pokemon series, or voice acting in general, whatever you like. Back in the back.
I have a few plushies lying around. I have a statue of Ash and Pikachu. It's like yay big. It's pretty cute. My mom actually broke it and I had to glue it back together. Yeah, no, she's a dunce. I love her so much. A couple of things. Yeah. But I also have a really cool Simpsons poster. I'm not denying it.
It's not a Pokemon-only household.
It's not a No, I'm not exclusive. Yeah. Back there.
Digimon or Yu-Gi-Oh?
I'm also in Yu-Gi-Oh, but Yu-Gi-Oh's funny. Yes.
What's your favorite non-Pokemon character to imitate?
Or
that you haven't done yet.
Favorite non-Pokemon character to imitate?
Or like one that you have already done yet, like not your own character that
something you've never done.
What's my favorite thing that I've never done?
Yeah.
Wow.
Like, that's one part of your job.
Wow. Favorite thing I've never done.
This is
yeah,
dude. Done. Just like, okay.
Something that's not on the Pokemon show.
Yeah. Like, not, like.
Something that I would like to do.
Yeah.
South Park.
Yeah.
All the time.
Everything.
Huh?
Which
one? Well, someone who's not there yet. What's another question? I want a new character. I want a character like made out for me. A little awkward and like really afraid of people.
Chin Pokemon.
Chin Pokemon. Small American people. I'm very sure. Yes. Oh God, I don't know. I'd probably just be playing with cats. I'd probably be editing video. I do a lot of that. I'm really into like international affairs and stuff. So I probably would have pursued all that much, much harder if I didn't fall into voice acting and, you know, love it so much and get all caught up in it. It's romance. Yes? Moment. I signed an ass. That was weird.
Like, I'm so curious about the like mechanics of
mechanics
how that
works. Yeah. No, he took it down of one butt cheek. I had a butt cheek in my face.
Did he give you the marker?
No, I think we had a marker.
I just assumed it was.
They usually give you a marker in these things. But, you know, it's a defining moment of my career. It was enjoyable.
Memorable.
Something I'd actually really remember.
You know, some people turn those into tattoos.
God. Yeah, if you're the boy with the ass sign, I'd like to know if you're seeing this. Tell me. Mm-hmm. Show it to me. Mm-hmm. Show me your butt cheek.
Do you really want to see that person again?
I just want to see his butt cheek.
Okay.
It's a true fan. I mean. Yes.
Why not?
Why not? Oh man. Voice acting is amazing. It's. Oh man, it was an accident. I was doing regular straight acting and, you know, suffering like most, and suddenly just I was auditioning for voiceovers, I guess. Voice that works. I fell into it. As most voice actors do, I think. They start out doing regular acting, you know, study acting and auditioning. Voiceover agents are just like, yeah, sure, go out for this and see how you do. I did okay. It's an amazing line of work. I can't complain. What other things did I do?
Yeah.
I didn't watch much TV. My parents didn't allow it. I did go through gymnastics for 8 years. Junior Olympic bronze medalist. Another career defining moment. I read. I sat in my room a lot. I'm an only child, so I was very isolated. I was home alone a lot. I would watch TV when my parents weren't home. I watched Undressed on MTV. That was really scandalous. Oh yeah. I was too young for that, but you know, education. Gymnastics, ballet, piano. I wanted to do karate, they wouldn't let me. Hung out with my grandparents. Yeah, no, weird childhood. Really weird, just full of work. I mean, I did a lot of, I don't know how people have time for like video games and stuff. I had a buttload of homework, like from every school that I ever had. I was doing homework for like 3 hours a night. Maybe it's different now. But it's not? You still get like a ton of homework, right?
Yeah.
How do you have time to just play video games?
You pick one and you commit.
Homework for what? Right. Do your homework, people. I mean, play video games.
Right. On the elliptical, on the bike.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Google's got a lot better, too.
Yeah.
Google or Wolfram Alpha can basically do your homework for you.
Yeah, see, we didn't have internet when I was a kid. Internet only started happening when I'm 29. So internet really... 2005 is when YouTube came out, right? I believe 2005. I graduated high school that year. Very sad. So I didn't really grow up with as many distractions. Sorry. Yeah, bullying is disgusting. I was bullied too, and then I kind of became a bully as a way to kind of counteract that.
Yeah. I also did Taekwondo growing up. My dad had a Taekwondo school, and I love the way that martial arts can kind of pull people in, and especially like,
yeah.
I don't want to say like freaks and geeks, but I mean people that otherwise don't fit into clubs or athletic clubs, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
And they find something that is
physical.
It's a great output. It's a great way to learn. Stress release and focus.
I'm glad you're still with us.
Yeah.
Don't let bullies lead you to that.
Yeah.
They're not worth it.
I tend to avoid bullies, or I don't like playing a lot.
Good.
I don't like fighting bullies a lot. They're annoying, but I don't like fighting them. It's not really worth it.
It's not worth your time, exactly. Life is short. Enjoy it. Stay away from bullies. They, I would say 99% of the time, end up being losers. And it's fun to watch them on Facebook, just fail. Question. Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
Do you have a favorite voice actor?
Ooh. Miley Flanagan, actually.
Wow.
She's become my favorite voice actor. Just her personality and the work she does has been amazing. Yeah. She'll be here tomorrow.
You, sir.
Is there any past or future voiceovers that you think would have wanted done in the past or that you want to do in the future?
South Park. Always and forever. South Park is, I grew up more on South Park, I would say, even than Pokemon.
Woo.
Yeah. I was too young when it started, and I just thought it was funny because they were cursing and being stupid, and then as I got older and older, it really shaped my taste for satire, and I really started understanding it, you know, on a more intellectual level, and I think it's absolute genius. Yeah.
Okay. What's the worst experience you ever had in a set or
a movie? Oh God, I remember it.
You remember it?
Yeah. I don't remember what it was like, an ESL kind of recording, and the director was giving me a note. And I thought I took it, but I guess not. And she was like, okay, so next time I need you to do this on the first take, not on the second take, okay? It's like, okay, sure. Great, I'm so glad we're friends. I did not work with her again. You know, you can't please everybody. Sometimes they're not gonna dig it, and they're gonna give you a note that you can't take, or you think you're taking and you're not really, or you are taking and you're doing a great job and she just can't hear it, maybe, I don't know, whatever, maybe she was having a bad day. Yes, I remember it. mean, I don't even care, I'll do anything, but I imagine it being a kid that's kind of buttersy, but I don't know.
For a show that just constantly churns out memorable characters, it's like,
yeah,
you really can't go wrong.
Yeah, that's true. Antifa. Is that a thing? Antifa? She's kind of like Antifa, but Antifa. Antifa.
A hot button episode.
Yeah, yeah. No, really, really
makes a lot of sense. It's where they excel. Very cool.
Antifa.
Over here?
Personal opinion is that yes, Serena and Ash are absolutely still together. I hope it's true. What do you think?
Well, because the expression I thought of, I kind of thought it the three just kept them on the list.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I think so too. I like the idea.
How do you feel about the part of Pokemon 20-year legacy? How do you feel about that?
Honored? Really honored. I still kind of can't believe that I'm part of something so big and that means so much to so many people. So it's a combination of honor and fear and humbling feelings. Yeah. I think that's, yeah. What's your favorite Pokemon? It's obviously Weedle. I know, very nice. Thank you for your question.
So, I have another question, and this is kind of theoretical.
Okay.
So, in previous arcs, they usually had the female of the cast, like, make a cameo. So, Ash is on Alola with three girls. How's Serena going to react?
I don't think Serena's a jealous type. I think Serena is kind of a cool girl, but who actually respects herself, but is also a cool girl. I also don't think Ash is going to play like that. I don't think Ash is the kind of guy who would, you know, start getting his hands on girls or anything like that. I think he's the kind who would be respectful and behave himself and go back to Serena when he's finished with his business in Alola. Any other questions? How to treat women? How not to be creepy? Don't get handsy. Yes?
Sorry, I got one of my dumb questions.
Let's get a dumb question out of you. What, who would win a knife fight, me and Ronnie Taylor? Oh dear. I'd probably just let her win. A lot of fans would be really happy if I let her win.
Sorry.
I don't know her skill level with a knife. I shouldn't say this, but I'm not very skilled with a knife, so I'd probably lose. Yes?
What's one of your favorite lines from movie or TV show that you would be willing to say as Ash Ketchum?
I can't actually do the voice. And the one line I can really think of is just a string of curses from Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. That would be really fun to do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Unfortunately,
yeah. 12, 13, 14 hours. It's not always, you're not always working, but if you're in costume, like I was 2 weeks ago, I was dressed as a clown, a very depressed clown who's under house arrest. It's great. It's the best thing I've done in a long time. So I had to go in full makeup every day. The wig, I still have like a line from it. So in voice acting, you just kind of put on whatever and you go to work. And if you're sick, you can easily reschedule. I was sick on that set. I could not reschedule. There was a huge crew and everybody was counting on me to be there. You gotta be there. I mean, the list goes on and on. But, you know, on-camera acting definitely has its merits. It's really fun. And yeah, I do love them both. But if I'm gonna do something consistently every week, the voice acting is so good. Do it. You should do it. You should all do it. If you can do it, do it. It's good stuff to do. Fraction of my time devoted to Pokemon. I usually do like anywhere from 2 to 10 hours a week on Pokemon. The most meaningful aspect of my work is meeting fans, and in particular meeting fans that grew up with my voice and seeing their faces light up. You know, people who are young, like 10 years old, under 10. Just like, oh my god. And they didn't know I was a girl, and then I do the voice for them and they just freak out, and that's, I don't have children, so other people's children made me really happy. Yeah. Anybody else?
What's your favorite legendary Pokemon?
I don't know. Zapdos? Is that a legendary?
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. Just checking. Yes. Yeah, Zapdos.
Okay, so like out of all the starters that Ash gets in every every region, I should say, is there one that you like wish he chose something else? Like what starter did you just really avoid?
There was one, and that's because I hated saying its name, and I can't for the life of me remember. You asked me that question, right? Or who was it? You asked
the hardest one to say.
The hardest one to say. I still can't remember. I've been thinking about it.
Describe it.
Yeah.
I don't remember what it looks like. I don't remember what it looks like. It was like 3 seasons ago at some point.
We're narrowing it down. It's a hard to pronounce
it's hard
starter
to pronounce.
Pokemon.
It's
not
that
big.
No.
Oshawott.
No,
Oshawott.
Huh?
Treecko. Treecko.
No. Treecko. That's crazy. All right, let me get some other starter Pokemon. Who's got them? Need a list.
Oshawott.
Well, that's kind of annoying to say Noctowl.
We need someone to take charge of this. Somebody needs to get on Google, look up the starters. We'll come back to you before the end of the panel.
Yes, I expect all this homework to be done within five minutes.
Yes.
No, those are originals.
OG.
That's OG, dude. I'm not OG. Second OG.
Blue frog fox.
There's that blue frog one,
the fish
that flying one.
Froki,
Oshawott,
Froki, Frenican, and Chessman.
Yeah.
Froki. Yeah, I don't like Froki.
What's Chimchar?
Chimchar. I like Chimchar. Chimchar's cool. Chimchar. Chimchar! Yes. Turtwig!
Turtwig.
Dude, I think that's it.
Turtwig.
I love Turtwig.
I love Turtwig.
You love Turtwig. Turtwig. Oh, yeah, yeah. I wanted to say Turtwig all the time. Turtwig, 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 Turtwig. Oh, yeah, yeah.
And it didn't involve with the grottle and then.
Yeah.
Torterra.
Torterra. That's better than Turtwig. I feel like there was another one, but Turtwig was definitely not my favorite. Yes, question.
In your social life or in dating, when you meet people who don't know who you are?
Two pharmacists in two different pharmacies. One in Queens, one in Manhattan. Next to my mom's house, next to my house. They like saw my name and they were embarrassed. And they're like, are you? There can't be two with the same name. Is this you? I'm like, yeah. I'm like, oh, they were very professional because they're pharmacists. You know, they can't just freak out behind the counter.
Sure. Because they're giving you free value.
Yeah, right? Hey. Yeah, that was very sweet. That was, you know, it's very unexpected when it happens. But no, I've never like made a new friend, and they suddenly no. Yeah, I'm not that famous.
I don't know if you said it yet. Funniest moment while recording.
Like redub things. It hasn't happened in a while. There was one director who would like to redub things with just like, you know, nasty little nasty things. But I never really partook in that much. I keep the funny outside of the booth. This is a very serious endeavor. A lot of children watch our show. So, way in the back there.
She was giving them.
She doesn't have a question. Okay, cool. Who else? Yes.
Well, I know Pokemon is pretty infamous for its usage of puns.
Oh, yes.
So is there one that you couldn't either just, like, not stand
or
tell? It's, like, really funny.
I have no problem with puns. I'm very punny. Okay. No, and I love it when there are musical theater references. Those are my favorites. I always get them. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I know who you are. You're my kind. Puns are great. There are people who have problems with it. I'm like, you have no sense of humor. Go home. Yes. Yeah, familiar. Will you perform it for us?
She'll perform
it. Do it.
Like your piglet, Nidoran, Binky, then so attacked up there, rope, pidgeys, the King, Chelsea on Dragonite, Gatsby, Pony, Tuffy, Warrior, on Poly, Rap, Bottom, Free.
Sick. Very nice. She knows it.
There's a panel.
She's my other half.
There's a panel at Comic Con about Pokemon raps.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
In San Diego? Right here, right now, today?
Yeah.
Oh my god, we should go.
You'll recognize the performer.
Okay. my god, can we get a preview?
No, Pokemon.
You should have a preview.
Yeah,
that was your pen. You're rapping. I can't even do the voice.
Oh, you've seen it. Were you here last year?
What time? What is your panel and where is it?
I don't know.
It's 3 of them.
It's soon.
It's at 4:30.
Thank you.
Oh my god. That's very exciting.
Pal to Plateau.
Yeah. I
bought
your album.
Wow.
There you go.
I bought your album.
Oh, thank you. I thought I recognized you, yeah. Yeah. I mean, Pokemon rap album.
We just met. I don't know.
Yeah.
Pokemon rapper.
Well, half the show is made up. It's freestyle. It's improvised, so I don't have to actually write that much.
So you like really do improv?
I really do it. Well, musical improv is different. You like theater, so.
I did musical improv. That's where I excelled.
That's, yeah.
And I did it.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
It's a beautiful thing.
It's a beautiful thing. You guys know about musical improv? real nerdy stuff.
Ooh.
Oh boy, nerds.
Dumb question.
Let's get a dumb question. You got another dumb question for me? I am ready for another dumb question.
The clock is ticking down, so we probably have time for just another question.
One more dumb question,
please. And then I would love to hear about your what you're doing at your table.
Okay.
Yes. So, yeah, you haven't asked the question yet.
You haven't had a question. Not with Ash, not anymore for sure, because I've been doing it for like 11 years. But yeah, sometimes when I play like really evil women, you know, it's hard to get back to not being evil. But it's a good day when that happens, you know, I guess you just kind of, because you really sink into that, you know, emotionally. So that feels good. Yeah, sometimes. I don't like my normal voice. I don't like being in panels and hearing my voice. It's weird.
She has a pleasant voice. She has a pleasant voice, everybody.
Oh, yeah, thank you so much.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Positive affirmation here. So, your table at the exhibitors hall?
Yes.
You're doing more than just signing.
I'm doing more than just signing. I'm talking to people. And I'm raising money for Voices for Fosters, which Lisa Ortiz and I started. We're promoting animal fostering. Welfare and education. A lot of people don't know how to take care of animals. They don't know what to do when they find a bird that's dying outside. They don't know what to do when they find a cat that may actually have kittens next to her. And you just take all the kittens. This is something that happened to me in my youth, and I took one of the kittens, and this is not the right thing to do. Anyway, we started a website. You should go check it out. This is preposterous.org. I'm selling Pokemon cards of all the Pokemon that I play. I have some rare ones, got some uncommon ones, I got a lot of common ones. And I have stickers that I put on the back of them, Voices for Fosters, and I sign them, and you can buy them. And you should come and do that.
All right, very cool. So we can visit at the exhibitors hall. In the meantime, let's give a round of applause for our special guests. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys.
All right, and enjoy the rest of your San Francisco Comic Con. We'll see you around.
Woo!
Hello, San Francisco Comic-Con. We hope you enjoyed this panel. Now, please check around your seat, gather your belongings.